have been in the field of water management for last 45 years. After completing my degree from IIT Kharagpur, I have been engaged in the profession of saving water all my life. Jain Irrigation System is the largest company in the world manufacturing micro irrigation systems, and it's a $1 billion company employing 11,000 employees. It has got presence in 130 countries all over the world, and we are the leading company in providing integrated agriculture solutions to the farmer, not merely trying to help the farmer save water, but also telling him how to produce more with less.
Sir, how farmers can conserve water by themselves?
See, without water, agriculture is not possible. In fact, water has become so important an issue now. We see there are virtually, you know, disagreements between states over the water issue. Agriculture is the elephant in the room as far as water is concerned, because it consumes almost 80% of available water. And now we have the new initiatives from the Prime Minister, like Make in India and 100 Smart Cities. So there's a very large competing demand from other sectors. And this 80% consumption of water in agriculture sector is a luxury which can't continue. So there's going to be more pressure on the agriculture sector, and unless the farmers learn to conserve water, learn to produce more with less by using technology, by using innovations, by simple systems. First of all, I think it starts with initially making attempts to store water. So they should go with the principle that mere gaon ka pani mera pani hai, which means that you do not allow the water to run off. So try and store as much water as possible in the field, in the community ponds, and use that water for irrigation purpose, for sanitation, for hygiene purpose. And then what all water is available, they must make every effort to use in the most efficient manner. Don't flood the field. It is the most unscientific way of irrigation, irrigating the crops. It is important that the crops must be irrigated in the very water efficient manner. Convey the water through pipeline, use the water, sprinkle the water, distribute the water in the field using sprinkler system or a drip irrigation system, which is the most efficient form of irrigation. And unless the farmers adopt new technologies, unless the farmers really are able to irrigate their crop, they will not get the desired results. So this is my message, that on this World Water Day, each and every citizen in this country has to pledge to make most optimal use of water, conserve water, and make sure that we use only as much water as is necessary for us.
Is it necessary to take this pledge only on World Water Day?
I couldn't agree with you more. In fact, this is everyday exercise. It's important that we do that. I personally go to various schools and teach school children. It starts with the children when they are young, I mean when we are young, and they also become message carrier to the family. So every day in our life we must see that water must be used in the best possible manner, and we do not waste water. Another thing is that as a country we must learn how to use wastewater. To give you an example, in Israel, city waste, or the waste of seven cities, sewage rather, is collected in one facility called Chef Dam, and there it is processed and pumped in pipeline all across Israel, particularly the Negev Desert, where nothing actually was growing earlier, and that water is used for irrigation purpose. So wherever this water has reached, it has created wonders. They grow fruits, they grow vegetables, and not even a single drop of the sewage water is wasted.